Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Rx3i power supply. This is an IC695PSD040. Basically, this test is to tell if you have a good working power supply or not, and what you're going to need in order to test the power supply. So a couple things. First off, I have the manufacturer requires an 18 volt DC to 30 volt DC input voltage range. So I'm using a 24 volt DC power supply, and I've selected a positive terminal for my positive lead and a negative terminal for my negative lead. Make sure that you guys have this wired right, that it's not backwards, okay? Next thing is I have the power supply switched off and I have an amber light. So what that means is it's detecting my input 24 volt DC power source to power the power supply. So that would be accurate. If you didn't have that light on and you were sure you had power going to it, then that would be some sort of a problem with the power supply and it would need repair or replacement. Now, when I turn the power supply on, I should get a green LED next to where it says power. Okay? That is typically a good functioning power supply so far, and that there is no power supply fault. All right. Again, if you don't get the green LED, but you get the amber LED, then there's something wrong with the power supply, and again, needs repair or replacement. All right. Now, aside from the 24 volt DC source that I'm using to power this, the other things that I'm using here is an IC695CHS007 seven slot rack. You're welcome to use a 012 or a 016 rack. I have an IC695CPE330 processor and an IC695ETM001. Now, it doesn't really matter what processor or peripheral devices that you use in here, as long as they have LEDs. And the LEDs indicate to me that the power supply is giving power to the backplane and it's powering up these modules. Okay, and I could tell because the CPE or the processor is able to go through its self-diagnostic and then stay steadily with a green LED, and same as the ETM001. So make sure that you have modules in the rack that you can power up and that you can see that they're on and working. And that would lead me to the third thing. Of course, if it is telling you that you have power but no modules are able to power up in the power supply, then again, it would be a power supply that's failed and needs repair or replacement. Another thing to bear in mind is just to make sure that when you pair a power supply with a processor, that the processor's requirements are met by the power supply. All right, and if you need to do some research on what would be a proper power supply for your processor, just check your user manual from GE, okay? A PSD040 is a power supply that we do commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.